would say, we don't like that light bread. We want better food. So God sent a fiery serpent pack to bite them. Note here, the way we often see it in the Old Testament is written by people inspired by their experience of God. They believe that if something bad to you happened to you, God did it. And if something good happened to you, God did it. And that concept changed through the Old Testament into the New Testament to the point that we got today's phrase, God so loved the world. However, we turned our back on that centrality of love in the gospel when we turned, whether it's to the south or to the north of us, to the identification of those who are sinful. I know it. They are it. When I grew up in Pittsburgh, we were taught in Western Pennsylvania history, as I think every school child is around eighth grade, taught about their local history, of Andrew Carnegie and the Gospel of Wealth. Well, I thought, well, I know he was a steel guy, but I didn't know he was a minister. And they went on to say what the Gospel of Wealth was. It was deeply imbued in Presbyterian Calvinism of the most severe kind, the same thing that brought you Vermillier's story. Except it was even more odious, because what the Gospel of Wealth said was that there are a certain number of people who are God's elect, and there's nothing they can do to become elect. They've been chosen. And there's nothing you can do who are not elect to become elect. And the way I know it is not because you're a blasphemer or an adulterer. That was the Litchfield version. That was the Puritan version. But in the Western Pennsylvania Scots Presbyterian version, it was, if you are rich, God has smiled on you, and you are one of the elect. And if you aren't, I think during a lot of the 20th century, we went a little too far on the other extreme. You would hear from pulpits, frequently in Episcopal Church pulpits, that wealth is bad. People who have it are bad. Well, it's not money that's the root of all evil. It's the love of money that is the root of all evil, Scripture says. It's all about our intent. It's all about the perspective. If we love money for money's sake, if we love food for food's sake, alcohol for alcohol's sake, none of these things in and of themselves are